Sometimes a Great Notion is a 1971 American drama film directed by Paul Newman and starring Newman, Henry Fonda, Michael Sarrazin, and Lee Remick. The cast also includes Richard Yekel in an Academy Award-nominated performance. The screenplay by John Gay is based on the 1964 novel of the same name by Ken Kesey, the first of his books to be adapted for the screen. Filmed in Western Oregon during the summer of 1970, it was released over a year later in December 1971. The economic stability of fictional Wakanda, Oregon, is threatened when the local logging union calls a strike against a large lumber conglomerate. When independent logger Hank Stamper and his father Henry are urged to support the strikers, they refuse, and the townspeople consider them traitors. All of the Stampers live in one compound, including Henry's good-natured nephew Joe Ben. Hank struggles to keep the small family business alive and consequently widens the rift between himself and his complacent wife Viv, who wants him to put an end to the territorial struggle, but is resigned to his doing things as he sees fit. Also complicating matters is Leland, Lee Stamper, Henry's youngest son and Hank's half-brother, who returns home with a college education and experience in urban living. A heavy drinker, Lee eventually reveals he attempted suicide after his mother killed herself and has been suffering from deep depression ever since. He urges the neglected Viv to leave. Despite the fact that he is uncomfortable living with a family he barely knows, Lee joins forces with them when they are forced to battle both the locals, who have burned their equipment, and the elements, which threaten their efforts to transport their logs downriver. After aiding their adversaries when their lives are in peril, the Stampers are handed two calamities at once: a falling tree that severs Henry's arm, and a trunk that crushes Joe Ben in shallow water. Lee takes his father to the hospital, while Joe Ben laughs at his own predicament until the tree trunk rolls atop him, pinning him down. Hank's desperate rescue attempts fail as the tide rises, drowning Joe Ben. At the hospital, Henry dies after finally expressing his approval of Lee, who informs Hank that Viv has left him. Hank returns to an empty home and appears for a while to have given up. Ultimately, he decides to deliver the logs, alone if necessary, but Lee joins him. Lining up along the riverbank, the Stampers' rivals look forward to seeing them fail, but the brothers are successful. Henry's severed arm is attached to the boat, giving the middle finger to all who watch. Although both Sam Peckinpah and Bud Boetticher had expressed interest in bringing Ken Kesey's novel to the screen, Richard A. Kahlo was signed to direct the film in May 1970. 5 weeks after principal photography began, Kahlo left the project due to artistic differences over photographic concept, as well as a required throat operation. At the same time, leading man Paul Newman broke his ankle, and the production shut down on July 29th. As co-executive producer, Newman considered replacing Kahlo with George Roy Hill, who declined the offer, so when filming resumed 2 weeks later, Newman was directing as well as acting. The fictional community of Wakanda was filmed in various locations in Lincoln County along the Oregon coast,